there, folks. My name is Ben, and I'm part of the Microsoft Entra customer experience team. Today, we're going to take a quick look at a scenario in which machine learning-based access review recommendations in Microsoft Entra ID governance can help reduce organizational risk. To help set the scene, we'll take a look at this slice of a reporting structure for a fictional organization, Contoso. You can see that most users report into Anushka over on the right-hand side of the image. Also note that there are two John Smiths within the organization, a pretty common name here in the United Kingdom. Contoso decides to create a security group called Sensitive Group to manage access to an app containing important Contoso information. Unfortunately, the wrong John Smith is added to the group by mistake. Not a great place to be, certainly not in line with the principle of least privilege. Let's take a look at how machine learning-based access review recommendations can help address this. So we're here in the portal, looking at the Microsoft Entra Identity Governance dashboard. Let's go ahead and spin up a new access review. We have the option of targeting Microsoft 365 groups, teams, and also security groups. Let's go ahead and find Contoso's sensitive group. We're going to hop over to the Microsoft Teams org chart in this tenant just for a moment. All of the users in the blue box are members of the sensitive group. The John Smith highlighted here will have high affiliation with his colleagues shown. They all report into the same manager. And here's the outlier John Smith. As this John reports into another manager, he will be considered to have low users of group affinity compared to everyone else in the sensitive group. This will be factored into the machine learning model that access reviews use. Now, back in the portal, we have the option of targeting only guests, but we'll go with all users in this case. In terms of the reviewers, I have the option of choosing the group owner, self-certification, or the individual user's manager. We'll just go ahead and pick the admin that I'm logged in with for this demo. The review duration defaults to 3 days, but I also have the option of adjusting that to meet my requirements. For this demo, we're going to go with a one-time review so we get to see the results quickly. We have a number of completion settings, such as removing access if reviewers do not respond. And importantly, we can decide whether Entra ID will provide reviewer decision helpers. For this demo, we need to enable the user to group affiliation option. Finally, we pick a name and description for the access review for easy future reference. After checking the access review settings, I'll go ahead and hit create. The access review will take a couple of minutes to move from a not started to an initialized and then to an active state. So I've sped up this particular portion of the demo. Once the status does flip over to active, we can dive in and confirm that the list of users to review has been successfully populated. Now, let's hop over to the MyAccess portal to see things from a reviewer perspective. If we click into the access review, you can see that a deny recommendation has been produced for each user. And that's because in this lab environment, the users are indeed inactive. If we scroll down, we see that John Smith 3, that's the outlier we highlighted earlier in the diagram, has also been marked as having low affiliation. If we drill into the details, the reviewer is informed that the user has low affiliation with other users in the group, a red flag. The reviewer decides to accept the recommendation and denies access, meaning that the outlier John Smith will have his access removed from Contoso's sensitive group and the important app that it grants access to. We've just seen how Microsoft Entra ID governance access reviews with machine learning based recommendations can provide key insights to reviewers, helping to ensure that only the right users have access to the right apps at the right time. Thanks for listening.